Final Fantasy V is an underrated gem, and you should play it. And today we'll be going over a few of the reasons I feel this is an underappreciated classic within the Final Fantasy mythos. Hello and welcome back to the channel, LC here. And today we'll be discussing why I believe if you're into JRPGs or Final Fantasy titles, you should definitely have Final Fantasy V on your list of games to play. I ended up playing the game recently during quarantine, and I was constantly amazed at how damn good of a title it ended up being. As a disclaimer, we'll try and keep spoilers to an absolute minimal, as I definitely feel this story has a lot to offer and should be experienced firsthand by new players. We're also on the road to 1,000 subscribers, so if you enjoyed the video and think Final Fantasy V is underrated, let me know what you think in the comment section and subscribe for future RPG and Final Fantasy content. Let's begin, shall we? You see, when it comes to Final Fantasy titles, I feel like outside of the big three, Final Fantasy 4, 7, and 10, that a lot of the mainline series don't get their rightful level of shine and receive enough credit for innovations they may have brought to the series, whether that be gameplay mechanics or story narratives. With the recent release of the Pixel Remasters and the game being available to play in probably its most realized version since its initial launch, there were a lot of my friends and peers trying out Final Fantasy V for the first time, and the feedback seemed to be almost universally positive on all fronts. One of the most common things that I heard repeatedly was, "Why did I wait so long to try this game out, and it's way better than I expected?" While I was pleased that their experience so closely mirrored my own from last year, a question slowly creeped into my mind. Why? Why was it that most people, even diehard Final Fantasy fans, had elected to skip over Final Fantasy V previously? Was it just possibly overlooked, or did perhaps its previous lack of availability potentially hinder its ability to find a modern audience? For disclaimers, I ended up doing my playthrough on the previous iOS PC port, which to my understanding most people were pretty indifferent about due to the art style changes, and thus it was kind of met to marginal fanfare. I'm probably one of the few people that actually appreciated the updated visuals, and while some things definitely felt a bit jarring, such as the character portraits to in-game visual translation, once you get past that, I felt that the vibrant and expressive art style really allowed the story of Final Fantasy V to shine through beautifully. To a certain extent, I will definitely say that this title suffers a bit from the middle child syndrome, with Final Fantasy IV being the first to push the series into much more of a drama-heavy and character-driven narrative, and on the other side of the fence, Final Fantasy VI being what many consider to be the best within the entirety of the series, if not one of the best JRPGs ever made. I felt a bit like the series director and the development team wanted to ease off the gas a bit in regards to extremely heavy narratives, and wanted to kind of just cut loose a bit. There's an almost invisible, mischievous undercurrent that runs through the entirety of the game and permeates every facet. At times, some of the game's dialogue feels like someone snuck in and added additional character dialogue when no one was looking, and somehow it just made it to print. Like seriously, at one point, one of the main antagonists actually shrinks down into a splinter in one of our characters' hand. I kid you not, this actually happened. This title also carries some of the series' best one-liners regarding a certain ancient turtle. In the best way possible, at times, this game felt eccentric, abstract, and a bit like a fever dream. I can't really stress how much different it feels than other mainline titles, as it's something literally built in every fabric of Final Fantasy V. Without being too dramatic, it definitely is the beating heart of this title. So why do I feel that Final Fantasy V is underrated? If I could answer that question in one word, I would say heart. Of the Final Fantasy titles I've played through, this definitely sits extremely high on the list as games that work to provide the player an extremely emotive experience throughout the playthrough. This, to my memory, is the only Final Fantasy title that didn't take itself as self-serious as the other titles, and wasn't afraid to do wild things like straight up break the fourth wall or introduce unhinged yet hilarious characters such as Gilgamesh to the fold. However, it never feels that its lighthearted nature was to a detriment to the overall narrative. Quite the contrary, it all works in service to the fantastic world building and providing player immersion. So yeah, Final Fantasy V isn't one big clown fiesta of one comical scenario after another. There's actually a very solid overarching storyline with its own stakes that keep the player motivated to see the story to its completion. And moving on to characters, I think there's one major recurring complaint that is constantly levied at this game a fair amount from my perusal of the old internet machine. One of the more common criticisms is that there isn't a strong standout character, a la a Tidus or a Cloud, or a layered supporting character such as a Kane or an Orin. I have to strongly disagree on this front. And while I would agree that Bart may not be written as his series counterparts, I believe he is more than serviceable as his gaming character. He fits the flow of the story being told like an absolute glove. One key thing I've grown to understand while playing RPGs is that different doesn't always translate to bad. I think that Final Fantasy is always better when the focus is on the cast as an ensemble piece, as opposed to a main character plus several supporting characters. That's probably why Final Fantasy XII is one of my favorite RPGs of all time. I think the same idea is executed in a similar fashion in Final Fantasy V in spades. While Bards might be our de facto leader, there is an equal character development given to each cast member, and at times it feels like this game could easily be helmed from any of their other POVs with no issues. The cast in question is definitely one of the most unique throughout the series, with Bartz being a bit of an atypical RPG protagonist from the start that gradually builds into his understanding of his role to play within the conflict of the elemental crystals. He comes into his own embracing the legacy of what came before and rising to the occasion on every front. Personally, I think his arc as a hero is quite underrated. And actually, that reminds me of what made me even want to try out Final Fantasy V to begin with. Back in my Dissidia NT playing days, Bartz was easily my favorite character. His high energy and lighthearted nature was often enough to bring me out of any funk that I might have been in. Win or lose, that was my guy. That's one thing that's beautiful about some of the more upbeat and hopeful heroes within the Final Fantasy series. Their positive attitude is extremely infectious, and this is definitely something I'd like to see the franchise revisit in the future. And while each cast member is quite exquisite in their own right, another standout is Galuf. I'm gonna try and keep it light here because of spoilers. He enters the story as an amnesiac separated from his world, and his arc throughout this game is perhaps one of the most satisfying, and it's good to see some old man rap within Final Fantasy titles. The gradual build and excellent character developmental arcs for our main protagonists conclude in satisfying conclusions for each of them. The game's focus on the power of friendship and how we're never truly alone when we have those we care for and those that care for us was extremely moving by the time the end credits started to roll. I loved every second of it. One thing about Final Fantasy V is that it has a sense of personality. This game is easily the funniest within the entirety of the series, and its delivery throughout the narrative complements character interactions as opposed to being used to force a laugh from the player at every turn. It's less MCU and more, say, a Spider-Man 2 when it comes to comedic element. The humor is there, but the game knows when to pull back and let events sit with the player and provide proper time for processing. The dialogue is extremely well written throughout the narrative, and it really serves to allow us to understand these characters and their interactions within the world and its inhabitants. Now I gotta talk about the battle and system mechanics, which I think were an integral part in advancing the entirety of the series. Now, while this wasn't the first in the series to have the job system, I think it's safe to say that it handily elevated it beyond all previous measure and made it a bona fide series hallmark. I mean, from Final Fantasy Tactics to Final Fantasy 12 to Final Fantasy 14, this system is everywhere. And I think that Final Fantasy V doesn't get enough credit for bringing it center stage. The depth and versatility within the design of the job system is one of my highlights within this title, and one that allows for endless player expression and creativity. No two runs of Final Fantasy V have to be the same. If you want to experiment with certain comps and skills, the option is always there, and this is one of the many ways that Final Fantasy V distinguishes itself not only as an RPG title, but within the totality of the Final Fantasy series. It created a system that is so robust that it's been implemented in numerous titles and is still actively being updated for newer titles as they come out. Real trendsetter vibes. And the last thing I'm going to close on is the musical compositions of this game. I feel they are tremendously underrated. While series staples such as Battle at the Big Bridge are known throughout the collective fanbase, I think as a total package, the OST is definitely on the higher side of the spectrum, having some truly standout classics like Ahead on Our Way, which give other series staples such as Final Fantasy IV's The Red Wings a pure run for their money. Everything comes together so well in this title from top to bottom, making the complete package a memorable experience for any JRPG or Final Fantasy fan alike. So who is this game for? I would say this game is for anyone looking for a change of pace from the traditional RPG or Final Fantasy formula. This is a perfect remedy for potential series or genre fatigue. In many ways, Final Fantasy V is the ultimate palate cleanser. So if you've got a chance to try out Final Fantasy V or you plan on picking up the Pixel Remasters, definitely put this title high on your list of next games to play. You won't regret it. And that's it for the video today, guys. I know this one's a bit of a quickie, but I wanted to get some of my thoughts out regarding the game while it was so relatively fresh. Again, if you dig the video, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. LC signing out. Peace!